I'm Andrew Mrazowski, the executive editor of The Silhouette.
And I'm Paula Scott, creative director at Underground Media and Design.
And today we are embarking on part two of our ghost investigation of McMaster Campus. But before we begin, I'm forgetting something. Okay, I think this is a little bit more appropriate. So we're going to be watching part two of the video. We're both in it, and we're just going to react. We're going to talk about what's happening. So let's just jump right into it.
Do you want to hold the Ouija board? I feel like this is a really bad Ghostbusters movie.
I would agree. I still feel like this is a continuation of a really bad Ghostbusters movie.
100%.
We need three people to take part. I'm not going to, because funny enough, I'm usually a block. It doesn't usually work with me, but I lead a lot of the sessions. So I don't know, Andrew, if you want to be one of
them. Sure, I'll be one of them.
Who else feels comfortable using the board? All right, come on up.
I really hope this does not
happen. And one more.
Yeah, me neither.
I'll do it if no one else wants to.
Yeah, that's perfect. Okay.
So why did you want to use the Ouija board?
I mean, I felt comfortable. I've kind of played around with them before when I was a kid and stuff.
What? Why?
I don't know, just, you know, girls having a sleepover and, you know, hanging out and
with
talking
the demons?
About ghosts.
Sure.
And, no, I don't know. Nothing ever really happened.
Okay.
But I just thought it would be fun.
And you used it a lot this night too.
I did.
Okay, so let's keep going.
So you're going to use two fingers on whichever hand you feel most comfortable with is fine. And just keep in mind that you want your arm as loose as possible, even if you have to lift it a bit, because it's a very subtle movement. So any resistance is going to cause it to not work correctly.
Okay. So we touch. And
go ahead and touch.
Just be like light. You don't like, press it down. Mm-hmm. Just like
very lightly.
That's a weird term, very nice. But light, yeah.
Can I just like rest my hand on it?
They were terrified.
They were staying outside, wanted nothing to do with it.
I don't think we have it in the video, but they were also playing loud Christian rock music.
They definitely were. I think they were saying a little prayer out there too. And
yeah, they wanted nothing to do with being in that room.
No.
So if there's something here, please come through and point to yes. We want to speak with you. Come on. Don't be shy.
I'm literally nervous. I thought it was one of you guys.
I'm not doing anything. I'm like barely touching it.
Are you moving it?
No. I honestly wasn't. I mean, I don't feel like I was. It's tough to say. Like, there's obviously people debate about how these work and that people are subtly moving it and that's how it works.
Subconsciously moving it.
Subconsciously, but I feel like I genuinely was not doing anything.
I also feel the same way, and I was actually trying to use the elbow pad to like keep my arm propped up, so like my fingers were just touching it.
Yeah, it's tough
like,
to say.
Yeah.
Experts and, you know, other people that are into this really debate that and say that we are moving it subconsciously, but honestly, I can say that I wasn't purposely trying to move it, and like you said, your fingers kind of just shake a little bit, but I can't see that being enough to like shift the planchette across the board.
Paula Scott, Ouija board expert. Okay, so the ghost said that it was there. So let's keep going.
So we can start with saying, is this the ghost from the hallway? Yes or no?
Really quickly, ghost in the hallway. Some of the MSU staff members, they said that at night when they were in the office by themselves, they felt like they heard footsteps in the hallway outside of the offices. At one point, felt like someone was looking into the offices as well. So that is the ghost that we are trying to communicate with.
Okay, so we're getting a little bit more.
Oh my God, why is it moving so fast?
Andrew, you better not just be pulling it.
I wish I was.
So yeah, well, everybody swear.
I'm not doing anything. I feel like I'm barely, it's the lightest pressure.
I'm trying not to move my arm.
Yeah.
This is on my part.
Yeah, this is common.
Yeah.
Okay, so we'll just go with that. Maybe ask another question if you wanted like a word answer or something instead of yes or no.
Maybe a year.
That's what I'm thinking.
Yeah, like what year were they born?
Actually, that's good. Yeah, that's a good one.
When were you born?
Yeah, what year were
you born? What year were you born?
You use the numbers at the bottom to tell us.
Please go fast.
Are you sure you're
not? I'm sure I'm not moving this.
I know. That's how I feel.
Okay, so again, it's what year were you born? Let us know. Okay, so one. Keep going. Here, let me try something. Let's keep the connection. And then let me just flip this. Okay, so just point. We got 1, 8, and continue on. Keep pointing to the numbers.
Nine.
Maybe it was trying to do 1, 9. But keep going.
Yeah.
It could be 1890 something.
Yeah, let's see.
Born 1896, McMaster, this version, McMaster campus opened 1930, so that would make that ghost 40 something years old. Probably not a student. And then Lauren, the psychic who was with us, said that she felt like this ghost was a trickster, was trying to like deceive us. What do you make of all that?
I mean, I think the ghost, if it was like more of a trickster, it did seem like there was some like conflicting information that it was giving us.
Yeah.
So I think that's totally possible. And maybe they were just lying about the year they were born and just like giving us false information the whole time, because none of it seemed to really like fit together and the timeline seemed a bit off. So.
And the planchette was moving so slow too.
It was.
Like.
Yeah.
It's part of the reason why we didn't include everything in this video is just because it would have been so boring to watch.
Yeah.
Like
yeah.
Everything was moving so slow.
It took
slow.
Forever to get like answers. It was just like very, very slow. And yeah, just like, again, it was such conflicting information that mm-hmm. I do feel like it was, you know, a ghost or a spirit trying to play a trick on us for sure. And just messing around.
Cool. Well, let's see what we had to say that night. You guys didn't move that.
No, I didn't.
No,
I promised.
I swear.
I was touching
my finger. I just
like,
moved.
I was literally like this.
I was like, touching I was it like with this much force.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Like that much
yeah,
force.
Exactly.
Now, did you guys want to move to the historic building?
Yeah.
We can kind of warm this thing up.
Yeah.
We can see what happens there.
Yeah.
Okay, let me pack it up here. Okay.
So next we are going to go to the basement of University Hall. I think we can all agree that that's probably the spookiest feeling place on campus.
Mm-hmm. So... would you say the MSU office is haunted based off of our investigation that we did?
I mean, I definitely know that people have had weird experiences up there, and it does get a little creepy. Like, I've personally had to like pop into the office when there was really no one there, kind of at the end of the day, and it's, you know, starting to get dark or whatever. It does, there is like a vibe for sure.
100%.
I haven't personally like seen anything, but I do get like a little bit of a strange vibe going in there.
A couple weeks after we did this video, I was up there with Elizabeth and with Sarfina and Hannah. I definitely felt like I kept seeing like things like looking at us. We were in one of the offices, so like looking at us through the windows and whatnot. I don't know if that was my mind playing tricks on me though. Then at one point I heard almost like beads, you know, on a window, like they have like the beads that you pull up and down to open and close the, mm-hmm. the blinds. Sounded like that hitting against metal. We don't have anything like that in the office. And then as Elizabeth and I were packing up to leave, we heard, and there's no one else in the office at this point, the loudest like banging noise coming from the kitchen space.
Interesting.
We left, we did not look back.
I don't blame you.
So yeah, if there is something there, I feel like we've aggravated it a little bit.
Maybe.
But based off the other things that happened that night, I feel like out of 5, it would be like a 2.
Yeah.
If it is haunted.
I would agree with that.
That is it for part 2 of the Ghost Investigation McMaster Campus. Make sure to follow and like for part 3, where I will be sitting down with some other fun people that we had on that night. For the Silhouette, I am Andrew Mrazowski, and we will see you next time.